there's a lot of levels as to why time travel is fascinating.
And action!
I think people are intrigued by the possibilities out there, and I think time travel would be something that would offer just endless possibility.
I think that time is an illusion.
I'm Brian Clegg, and I'm a science writer. My background's in physics, and I've written a book called How to Build a Time Machine. If you look back, really people have been interested in what time is forever. People have thought, what would happen if I could move into the past, move into the future? What would things be like?
We're kind of lashed to these however many years we have on the planet. And, you know, part of why history is also so fascinating to us is the notion of jumping out of that timeline. And the bigger thing, and this plays maybe more into Looper, is fixing mistakes. The notion that you can go into the past and fix a big mistake you made.
So do you know what's gonna happen? You done all this already, as me?
I know two things. I know what's happening in my head, and I know that you're still gonna meet her. Oh. She's gonna save your life.
I think when you think about traveling to the past, the thing that springs to mind immediately is what would happen if I changed things? What would happen to the future? And we get paradoxes emerging.
So you're gonna kill this guy, your own self.
And so it's quite scary when you look back on your life and you think, God, if I hadn't gone to that restaurant, I wouldn't have met that person who wouldn't have introduced me to that, and I wouldn't have done that. And when you clock them up, it's quite spooky.
You know, who knows what the consequences could be.
There've really been two ways of looking at time travel in fiction. Early on, it was fantasy. So it was the idea that you would be magically transported to another time. I think the best known one is Mark Twain's Connecticut Yankee in The Court of King Arthur, where he gets a knock on the head and that transports him somehow magically into the past. But it was H.G. Wells who transformed that and took a scientific view and said, maybe time is just another dimension, something we can move backwards and forwards in, just as we can move in the space dimension. And he'd be proven right in just maybe about 10 years' time or so, when Einstein started to come out with his theories. Einstein managed to link time and space through relativity. What he tells us is that if you move quickly, then time slows down for you. And effectively, that's a way of traveling into the future. Traveling into the past really takes remarkable technology.
This time travel crap fries your brain like an egg.
People have thought that time travel just couldn't be possible because nobody's ever seen any visitors from the future. But in fact, there's nothing in the laws of physics that says it isn't possible. The time machine is projecting you into the past down this 30-year corridor.
You can't dial it up or down. So basically, it's going to send you exactly 30 years, 3 months, 2 days, 8 hours, and 5 seconds back. And as it's kind of like a sliding thing. So as time keeps going, the point at which you're going to be sent back to keeps sliding forward also.
There's a very interesting parallel between the time machine in Looper and the way a time machine based on a wormhole would work. A wormhole enables us basically to link one point in space and time and another. It's like a bridge and enables you to travel through. And just like in Looper, when you appear at the other end, you're effectively appearing out of nowhere. There would be no way to go back. You're trapped in the past.
Bruce is the older version of this man, and I'm the younger version of this man.
It's really a strange thing to see someone that looks like a young version of yourself.
If you time travel, then there's a possibility that you may run into yourself. And people have thought a lot about, would the two people somehow destroy each other, implode in some way? In fact, as you go into the past, this is a different person. It's even physically different.
He's on a run.
In the movie, when time travel's invented, it's almost immediately made illegal.
It's incredibly dangerous and they shouldn't be messing with it.
Like cloning of human beings or use of nuclear devices by terrorists, the government is basically just gonna say, no, this isn't a good idea.
And it's kind of been driven underground and the only people who use it are these mobs. Time travel is messy.
I'm gonna fix this! I'm gonna fight him! I'm gonna kill him!
The smartest men in the future know one thing about time travel that we don't. They know to be scared to death of it.
I think one of the most original ideas in the movie is that the younger version of Joe can put a message on his arm, actually carve a message into his arm, and then that message is received by the older Joe, and it's been there for the last 30 years.
And that kind of thing really interested me, how you signal to yourself.
Must hurt.
Wasn't sure you'd remember her.
Yeah, I put it together.
Pour vous.
When the older Joe goes back into the past, he starts losing memories. He's having really to hold on to the memory of his wife because the younger Joe, for instance, has met a different woman.
And so he's in this rather desperate position of trying to gain that life back.
He's struggling to keep in place the way things were, where perhaps he never even meets that wife.
My memories aren't really memories. They're just one possible eventuality now, and it hurts.
I think the idea of linear time, past, present, and future, is a convenient construct that we animals have devised in order to survive, but it's not necessarily the true way that the universe exists.
Einstein had a nice little story to illustrate this. If you're sitting on a hot stove, then a minute seems like an hour. If you're sitting with a pretty girl, then an hour seems like a minute.
I don't want to talk about time travel shit. Because if we start talking about it, then we're going to be here all day talking about it, making diagrams with straws.
We know time travel is real. We've even got evidence of things traveling in time. The GPS satellites that do satellite navigation have to be corrected for the fact they actually drift slightly in time against the time on the surface of the Earth. If we think about inventing a real time machine, I think, practically speaking, we are a reasonable distance off in time. If you think back to the way things were at the start of the 20th century, there's no way anyone then could have imagined many of the things that we consider every day now. And of course, who knows, with the way technology has developed in just the last few years, it really could be possible sometime in the future. Would I want to travel back to the past? It's a difficult one. I would be scared that I would do something that would change the future badly, but I think it would be too tempting.
Why not? I'd do it.
I mean, as long as I could come back, I'm curious about like what's ahead, you know, in my life. So I wouldn't do any sort of permanent time travel.
I'd like to take a little trip through time. I'd like to see the world today before I see the world anywhere else, though.
If I could actually meet my older self, that's hard to say. I could tell you what I would do if I met my younger self. I'd slap him in the back of the head. Say like, just calm down. Everything's okay.
I don't know if it's that people have some kind of regret that they want to correct in some way.
And that ends up being one of the big questions that the movie poses, if not answers.
It's an amazing thing. Going backwards in time, disturbing. And yet, really cool.